Hey all. I wanted to run through this Eddie Cochran tune. It's more or less in what to listen for as opposed to what to play, because the chord shapes are easy enough, but a couple of things to listen to or listen for when you're trying to figure a song like this out by ear. So I'm going to go through it. It's only 2 minutes, so I'll go through it and then let's talk about it a little bit. It's tuned down a little bit, and once you try to sit down and try to play with it in standard tuning, standard pitch, you'll hear that. So low E goes down to this, and you can tell one guitar is doing this shape, this tuning. But if you listen to the, for me, oftentimes I'll try to listen to the high strings, the high end of the chords, right? So this one, you can hear it goes. You can hear that at the top. So I know already it's going to be. You can also hear. You can hear that going on in there. You can hear that in the middle of the chord. So it's clearly this. I think the electric is going. For that, the bridge part. But that's one guitar. Pretty easy to hear that one. The other one, if you listen close. Like I said, you can hear at the top end. So that would be tuned the same way. I mean, you wouldn't have to tune this one down. You could just capo appropriately, but I tuned this one down a half because it's easier to sort of illustrate it. So this one's in D, well, in the key, the same key as the other one, but with D shapes, It's actually, what would it be? A B flat, is the actual key of it. You can hear that going. So when I play it, along with it, and then you listen to it, it's probably easier to hear it. But if that's one thing to listen for, is that other guitar isn't doing that high. The other one obviously isn't doing that. There's two of them going on. Mixed a little lower on the second guitar, but it's there. So let's try this.
I'm
little subtlety there is the other guitar without the capo is doing it as the five chord is doing it as a B7, you know, half a step down, but as B7. This one doesn't sound like it's a seventh chord, it's just straight D or, you know, E flat, but with these shapes. Without a seven chord on that last one. So try and listen to that one, listen to the studio one just on YouTube and see if you can hear the two things going on. A little one to practice on in terms of the listening, not the playing of it because it's easy to play. But in terms of it, if you don't know a lot about Eddie Cochran, look him up on online. Would have been a huge, huge star. I mean, was anyway, but would have been much bigger if he hadn't died so young. But a lot of really cool sort of, I don't know, revolutionary is the word, but he was at the front end of recording techniques and overdubbing and playing multiple instruments all by himself on the sessions and stuff. A great catalog of music to learn on if you're trying to figure out how to play things or how to learn things by ear. Good luck.